EDIUS version 8.22 introduces a few new features. We'd like to present some of them today. The EDIUS installer has been changed and no longer needs Apple QuickTime to have been installed. This change was necessary as certain security issues in the QuickTime player for Windows have not been fixed by Apple. Video codes and still image formats, which previously needed QuickTime in order to edit them, can now be used natively in EDIUS. An important new feature is that Apple ProRes material can be imported and edited natively in EDIUS without QuickTime. QuickTime only needs to be installed to allow the importing of special formats like the QuickTime Animation Codec or for QuickTime Export. There are also changes in the primary color correction. In EDIUS 8.22, we have extended the choice of color spaces. It is also possible to import lookup tables now, so-called LUTs. LUT files can be recognized by the ending .cube. With these, you can give your material a unique or special look. EDIUS version 8.22 also makes much more use of the graphics card. As with 3D transitions and raw decoding, the primary color correction performance can also be improved by using a high-performance graphic card. This leads to a significant improvement in performance, especially when adding primary color correction to multiple clips. Even Intel QuickSync support has been improved. QuickSync is an acceleration method integrated into many current Intel processors. EDIUS 8.22 is now able to use the latest Intel GPU drivers more efficiently. This improves the performance both for editing and for H.264 export in many systems, especially for those running Windows 10. In EDIUS 8.22, the user interface has also been enhanced. Apart from various small changes, there is now a visible centerline in the audio waveform when audio is interrupted. Also, the selected Kia is now displayed in grey. A new function in the GV browser is that a clip can now be opened by a listed application via the right-click menu